हरे ओम। आई होप यू माइट हैव अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ सवितर्क समापत्ति इन सूत्र नंबर 42। एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दैट वाज द प्राइमरी लेवल ऑफ सवितर्क समापत्ति, अ प्राइमरी लेवल समापत्ति कॉल्ड एज सवितर्क समापत्ति। नाउ इन नेक्स्ट सूत्र नंबर 43 ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग द एडवांस लेवल ऑफ समापत्ति, दैट एडवांस लेवल इज निर्वितर्क समापत्ति। स्मृति परिशुद्धौ स्वरूप शून्यव अर्थमात्र निर्भाषा निर्वितर्क, दीज आर दी वर्ड्स इन सूत्र नंबर 43। निर्वितर्क समापत्ति, बट वितर्क इज स्टिल देयर, एंड वितर्क मीन्स आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन दैट इज ए स्थूल ऑब्जेक्ट विच यू कैन परसीव थ्रू द सेंस ऑर्गन। ऑब्जेक्ट इज सिमिलर द सूत्र नंबर 42 ओनली, but in 42 there was some confusion of different knowledges I explained. Now Patanjali gives that the yogi goes beyond that. That is why he says smriti parishuddha. Smriti is memory. So the word, the meaning and the knowledge about the word, and also the vikalpa, knowledge through the vikalpa, is all stored in memory. And that is why it is getting confused, because that memory continues in stage of samapatti also. But now he says smriti parishuddha, that memory has become totally pure. It means everything is removed from the memory. Of course not permanently, but during the process of samapatti, during that process only. So memory is totally removed. That is why it is saying parishuddha means cleaning. When we clean something, we remove all this dirt and things. Similarly, we have to remove everything from the memory. There everything is disturbing the state of memory, purity of memory. So whatever is there in the memory is all impurities. That is why he's using the word parishuddhi, that is totally pure, we can say. So memory has become totally pure. That is, nothing is there in the memory during the process of samapati. And then Swarupa Shunya, because there is no memory, that I, the Atman or Purush, is connected with memory, but there is nothing in memory. So that I presently is connected with everything, my body, my mind, my actions and all that, but that is all, everything is because of memory. And the memory is totally removed, Smriti Parishuddha, that I becomes known to himself. What is I? Only I. Nothing is there. That means his swarup it is used. Swarup also which can be perceived through the sense organs. I is energy. We cannot perceive I or Atman or Purush. But when I is connected with body-mind complex and all that, then it has got some identity. You can call it as an identity. But when there is no memory, there is no identity at all. And without any identity, it is called Swarupa Shunya. But Patanjali is using the word eva. Eva means as if. So this identity is lost, but not permanently. So he is using as if the identity is lost. And it is lost for a short period during the process of samapatti. And Arthamatra Nirbhasa. Artha is referring to the object. Nirbhasa means it is enlightened. So there is the enlightenment of the object only. And losing the identity totally, as if. And because there is no memory. So all these words are connected and all these things are there. And that stage is called Nirvitarka Samapatti. Now you can discriminate between Savitarka and Nirvitarka. You can understand it. Savitarka is a very primary level. Nirvitarka is very high level. Because everything is lost there. No memory, no identification. But only object is there. And the mind of the yogi, along with the I, that Purusha, is merging with the object. So only object is enlightened. Nothing is there. And this stage is much more nearer to the final stage of samadhi. Now in next sutras, Patanjali is still giving some advanced practices. Let us see afterwards. Hare Om.